Prop G have to be interpreted on a project-by-project basis?
That's the question.
I am.
Won't Prop G have to be interpreted on a project-by-project basis? I assume everything has to be interpreted on a project-by-project basis, and any project that would require payment to state or using state or federal funds would be prohibited. Any project where the developer themselves decided to sign a labor agreement, people like SEG&E, they have project labor agreements on everything they do because they found it's a good, smart business practice. So because they have PLAs that include the undergrounding of utility lines, yeah, that might have to be looked at and said, we can't put any city funds into that. I don't know about you, but I want my utility lines undergrounded. You know, when a company comes and they want to do a peaker plant because that old, outdated South Bay power plant needs to be torn down, but most, if not all, peaker plants in the state of California are now built under project labor agreements, the only way to ensure that they're done right, on time, and under budget. But if that company decided that that's what they were going to do, then any funding, whether it's the land or the subsidy to have some kind of infrastructure that the city would need to put in, couldn't be done. This is the only way we're going to get rid of the South Bay power plant, and even that could be prohibited because the tearing down of that's going to require a mix of both state prevailing wage funds and local funds. Even that's going to be prohibited by this initiative.
It will be interpreted on a project by project basis, but even more specifically, it needs to be interpreted on a contract by contract basis. The myth that's being perpetuated is that if there's any state funds, Prop G bans this activity. That's not true. What Prop G says, on a contract that the city controls, a city contract for public construction, there can't be a project labor agreement. So is it a city contract? Does the city control that contract? Not does the state control it, or the feds, or the port, or a private developer. It's a city contract. When you do an initiative in a city, all the voters can do is have the same power that a city council can do. When we passed Prop C, we said the city council cannot do certain things in eminent domain. Prop G is similar. It says the city council cannot do certain things in how it lets out contracts. It can't make a union-only contract. The city does not have the power to tell the state or the port or the feds or a private developer what to do. Prop G controls the city activity, just like Prop C controls the city activity. It's very narrow in that respect.
I have written questions, and I'm going to ask the two sides. Do you want to field any questions from
the audience?
No.
What guarantee will the city give that they'll be hiring legal workers on this project?
Okay. I recognize.
I'm a federal law professor, and I don't think the city or the city council or the mayor want to go against federal law.
The bottom line is, right now, the only way to ensure that local workers are hired, that you know that those workers are people who live and pay taxes in Chula Vista, is through labor agreements. This takes away that ability. So although I'm sure the city council, who is opposed to Prop G, would not want to be hiring people who aren't here legally, it wouldn't be in their control or purview because it's the contractor and the subcontractors who make those decisions. Under labor standards now, you have some assurances. Under Prop G, you have no assurances. And we've all seen, anytime there's any kind of big building in Chula Vista, you can go to any of the motels, and all it's a little good business with motels. Just look at the license plate of the trucks sitting there. They're from like Arizona and Nevada, places where people will work very cheap. We also know that people come up from Mexico to work on those projects. The only way to ensure that it's local hire, that people from Chula Vista are working on those projects, is through having labor agreements. And that's why on big projects, that could be a priority.
Thank you.